So yeah, I think today is the day of integration. What say, Hardeep ma'am, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
So we are all talking about integration. So welcome to the session of integration. And as ma'am said, we all are inspiring each other. So I got so much inspired by the Powtoon. I thought, why not let's try our introduction through Powtoon. So earlier we were working on PPT for the introduction. So this is a small try. So I would like to welcome you all with this introduction of the third-party apps. So basically what I feel nowadays is A for Adobe, B for Bunsy, C for Code.org, D for Drawboard, F for Flipgrid, I for Insights, M for Mergecube, N for Nearpod. Oh my God, I am tired. So A to Z, every alphabet has got N number of applications with them. I think I was studying it a bit and I couldn't come across X as in Xmas. So I didn't find any applications, and I'm sure our IT people are going to work hard, and very soon we would get some wonderful application with X as well. So let's see what the app integration is all about. Good afternoon, respected principal ma'am and my dear wonderful educators. Today in this session we would learn about third-party apps integration. Hardeep ma'am and myself Sharda would take you through a session on third-party apps integration. Integration is a way of adding slices to find the whole. Let's see our applications. Please take screenshots to redeem the code. So I request you all to take screenshots, and Hardeep ma'am, I would request you to please paste this in the chat window as well.
So sure, ma'am, definitely. I'm trying it, but I don't know, some problem is there for the chat window today. I have no idea
No
what's happening.
worries, no worries at all. I'll go ahead and do it once this is done, not to worry.
I have already done it. Okay.
That's great. So SPB95DB21. With this, I proceed. Educators, stay tuned.
Yes. Thank you, Sharda ma'am. It's really wonderful. Thank you, everyone.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's begin. This is our playground. We need to go to our Teams, click on General, and then click on the plus option. We will get n number of applications. Based on our requirement, we will choose one of the applications that we want to add in our class Teams. We need to click on the app, and then we need to click on Save button down below. So let's begin the fun.
Thank you so much for your. So today I would be telling you about three applications which we have partially we know them already, and partially we would come to know today. So as I said earlier, A to Z, we have n number of applications. So the moment I click on plus, these are all the applications which are available to me. You see here, this is the recent one. So these applications are in the recent ones which we were studying and trying to embed test something or the other. And these are more tabs. If you click on this more apps and more tabs, you will get any number of applications which is used for different purposes. So the moment I click here on the left hand side, you can see below the apps you have this all thing or the personal apps, bots, tabs, connectors, messages, based on our requirement, whether we want an analytical app, we want a developer app, an education based app, we need to click on this. So the moment I click on education, these are few applications which have been proposed, keeping in mind the education thing and keeping in mind our remote learning sessions that we are continuing. So first of all, the most well-to-do or most sought for application nowadays here is Insights. So I need to select the Insights tab. The moment I open this, it is giving me the option. Another important thing, dear educators, make a note of this. Whenever you want to apply or integrate an app in your class Teams, it will give you an option of this drop down. If it gives, that means you have a place to adopt for it. That means add to a team. It is giving me, I have an option of adding this Insights to a team. However, the moment you click on it and you get two options like class, chat or teams, that means you have an option for adding that application either to your chat or to your team. I'll tell you a short difference what we have. Team means an individual access to the individual teacher. Chat means to the links that we are creating for accessing our classes or taking a remote learning session or for any meetings or for any specific group. That's a basic difference. I want to add this insights to the team. I need to click on add to a team. Now it will ask me which team do you want to add upon. I have already added this to all my teams where I have access, grade 1 to 5. So it might not let me an option, but still I'll go ahead and try. So this is the drop down. The moment I click here, it will give me the number of classes that I have. So it said insights will be available, but you can start using it in the channel you chose. Okay, so I can use it in the specific channel also. The moment I have selected the class, I click on set up a tab. It's processing. I hope I am not very fast or so. Okay, so it says slow down. You are going a little bit too speedy. Let's see what it has to say. And it is giving us an option of post to the channel about this tab. Last time when we had attended a training, the resource person was saying that you should not be clicking it because this is for the teachers and not for the students. So I still am in a dilemma. We can click this or we may not click this, but however, it still remains same. Good thing about Insights is this is a platform which gives the digital report card of each student of our class. Whenever we are conducting classes and once we have integrated Insights in our class, after a week or so when we will go back and see the report card, when the student has logged in, when they have logged out, or the number of assignments submitted, their activities, their chats, their communication, everything is visible in the Insights. This Insights application is also going to help us as an educator, as a mentor, as a guide for our students to conduct the parents-teachers meeting as well. We do not need a separate separate attendance sheet or so. We can go ahead and maintain everything in the Insights. This is also AI-based, artificial intelligence-based. It's a very smart application. It gives us all the input. If you can see here, it shows track student activity, discover communication activity, and not only from now, it would be giving us all the options from the day the class has begun. Another request from my side would go to all the educators going forward, please give all your homeworks, all your assignments through the assignments tab in your teams only. The reason being, Insights would again track it. Whether the children have viewed the application, viewed the assignment, whether they have submitted it, whether they have returned it, whether we have marked it, graded it or not, everything would be available on the Insights. If I click on this, it will give me options of going detailed report of each student of my class. And this Insights tab stays here as soon as we integrate. I'm just opening the Excel sheet. We can download it in the form of Excel as well. We can see it from here as well. All the digital activities. So this will help us improve one more step ahead and lead our students in developing 21st century learning design skills like collaboration, communication, self-regulation especially. And when we tell students that yes, we are keeping a track or we have the information and we can even motivate them, encourage them with the information that we gauge from Insights as a class. So they would also definitely be self-regulated and they will try their best to work upon. I can show you Insights of another class that we have used already, which has got lots of data. So I'll just go to another class where I had added the teams thing. Okay. This is the one. I click on general. You can see Insights tab here. So the moment I click on Insights, it's again giving me the report card. And we will strive a step ahead to achieve SDG 4 as well in developing quality education within our students. You can see the color combination here, color coding, what we call it. Green stands for something which is good, or we should be doing more of this. Red stands for something which needs our attention and which needs our time there. So it says 26 students were absent from at least 13 meetings. 22 students were often late for meeting last week. The moment I click on this, I can see the names of those students as well. I'm just hovering the cursor, you can see here. So this is what Sabreen, Sai Kanish, Cheshta, I can see the names. And when it shows great news, all your students were active in December. Active in the sense, the chat that they have mentioned, or they are mentioning any homework of their activity. I just wanted to show the date, how is it visible. See, this is the report card and it shows this week. So when I click on this and I go previous month, it will take me to the report of December. So now it's giving a whole class report. See, the red thing, drill down to see details, purple thing. So student wise report is here. We can just drop it down, scroll down, and we get all the students' information here of our class. You can have a quick look. How does it look? December 31st, December 1st, the whole month data is here. At the same time, if I want to get specific student details, I just need to click on this all students thing. And I suppose I want to see for this child, I'll just click this child's name. And now it's going fetching me details of this specific child. So if I just remove this, so this is one. First period, second period. So it is giving me with the timings as well. And if I say all activities, it is giving me all activities. I can click on meetings to get information. I can click on communication. So whatever chat or their homework they are sending, or they're communicating with teachers about asking doubts or so, everything, whatever activity we are doing in the teams would be visible here. So this is about insights, which is a very friendly tool. However, every tool has got some limitations to it. I would like to inform that limitation to insights is it can be accessed on a laptop. So we can take a screenshot, we can take information details from here and share with our parents and guide our students as well, and keep a track for ourselves as well, that this child is the one on whom I need to focus more. This child needs my hand holding. This child needs a special appreciation. This child needs a praise for his work. This child is good to collaborate for any type of activity which needs collaboration. So that is about insights.